So one thing that really stood out the most on your page and really drove us to see your content was the username. So what is the exact idea behind the name Modern Mirabai?
Thank you, Gauri, for inviting me here. First of all, it's such a pleasure to be here with you. Well, the name Modern Mirabai, I think it has come from my soul, frankly speaking. Lowest of your self-worth, and your Bhagwani to yaad aata hai, right? You end up remembering the God when you're in the lowest of your phases. And that's where my connection with the higher power got stronger. आई ऑल मतलब भगवान को मानते थे हम, बट द कनेक्शन रियली ड्रू स्ट्रॉन्गर व्हेन आई वाज एट द लोएस्ट फेज ऑफ माय लाइफ. इट सो डज हैपन दैट व्हेन अ वुमन इज वल्नरेबल, अ लॉट ऑफ मेन अराउंड हर सेंस हर वल्नरेबिलिटीज एंड ट्राई टू कम इन हर लाइफ ओनली टू टेक एडवांटेज ऑफ हर. Getting cheated and, you know, again, finding it difficult to trust anybody, you again draw yourself to somebody who you know will never, harm you. And that is the spiritual aspect. So, me being a romantic person, and all girls are, you know, we listen to Bollywood romantic songs. And when I would actually sing those songs, you try to have a personification, an image of somebody in your mind. And I did not have any, right? So I started dedicating all my songs to the Supreme Almighty and to a point where I actually fell in love with this supreme power. It's the purity of the love, if you can call it. Even the bhajans, you know, I would consider these romantic songs as bhajans to the Almighty. You're expressing your love in any form for that matter, right? Ek bhajan tha usme se, there was one of them where it said that, it had a zikr, usme zikr tha Meera Bai ka, Meera ka zikr tha ki, and that is where the word stuck to me that yes, I am a Mirabai. You know, in this modern world where I'm staying, I may not be wearing orange saffron clothes, but I still am connected. I still love the Almighty in the best of his form. I may not be able to physically see him, but I love him still. I know he's there somewhere taking care of me, a lone girl in this world who's trying to make her mark. And that's where the Mirabai was born. The modernism in the Mirabai is the fact that she stood up for herself. Mirabai herself was a rebel in her society, by the way. She was born a princess and she chose to live her life as a Sufi saint and, you know, in the love of God. She chose not to abide by the rules of those kingdoms and princes and whatever, and live her own life. I saw that same sentiment in me when I chose to live my life by my own terms and conditions, and that's where the modern Mirabai came in. I started my blog way back in 2013. I just used to write, express myself, but slowly and concretely over the 7 years, it has taken the form of this movement where I really want to work with people who have gone through the same experience as me. So that is Modern Mirabai for me. Got it.
That's a really interesting take on it. So my next question
Thank
for
you.
you is, so what exactly was your childhood like? What did you want to be growing up?
Okay. And I'll be very honest with you, Gauri, here. Young girls in UP, where I was born and brought up, you know. Men still, the young boys are still taught to be ambitious, but the young girls are never told to be having a career, you know, a life plan for themselves. Parents want her to study so that she can get married. And she studies so that she can stay. मैं पढ़ाई करती थी और गर्ल स्टडी ताकि वो घर के कामों से दूर रह सके. और माँ पापा पढ़ाते थे ताकि कल को उसकी शादी करा सके. सो देर वॉज नो सीरियस, यू नो, अ गर्ल इज एजुकेटेड देयर टू बी गेटिंग मैरिड एज सच. दैट्स द पॉइंट आई एम मेकिंग. एंड आई वॉज डिसेंटली गुड एट स्टडीज एंड आई चोज टू कंटिन्यू टू स्टडी as a means to stay away from getting married. You know, there are a lot of fears when you're growing up, when you're reaching 18, 19, all your relatives start telling you get married. 21 is high time and she's not married. And I continued, and I sensed that if I continue to study, maybe I'll stay away from marriage for a while. And that's where I moved out of home. My father immensely supported me in my studies. He always believed in financial independence of women. He's strongly vocal about it. And he wanted me to, aspire. The fact that I moved to Mumbai to pursue my studies, all credit goes to him. And after that, again, my dadaji wanted me to get married, come back. Now you've studied, right? Now come back, get married. But again, it was my father who supported and said, let her work for a few years. She has studied all this while. So I really am indebted in that case for, my father being so supportive in that journey. It so happens that I eventually fell in love with the guy and got married after 5 years of my work career. And that is where I got attached into digital marketing. So, digital marketing is my first love, if I could say. I've been a digital marketer all my career life. So, but yes, again, I was asked to leave my career and become a housewife for the man whom I loved and I wanted to get married to. And I loved him enough that I agreed to leave everything. So career-wise, there was, I was not that serious for that matter. I loved my independence and the financial freedom that I got from it. But aspirationally, there was no direction initially that really was. The passion, the life purpose, all came in after you go through the lows of your life, really. And you experience that you really don't want to be there. So that is how I came to where I am today.
That's really inspirational, if I have to say the least. So what led you to create what you have created today?
To get married to that man, I had to come face to face with a lot of sacrifices. And I was not prepared for it. I thought I love him enough to be able to sacrifice everything. And that's what girls are taught. The upbringing is that your happiness is the happiness of the family that you're around. I got married into a Gujarati family, and things from the third day itself of the marriage started going down south. My parents were not speaking to me for 1.5 years because I chose to get married by myself. And I also took major decisions in life of quitting my job and career, which my parents were not okay with. With no backbone, emotional backbone behind me, and with the in-laws who were not supportive of the marriage because it was a different culture, it left me very vulnerable emotionally. Whom should I hook on to? Fast forward, if I could say, things really went down south and I came out of it. My parents eventually came to rescue me from there. And next 7 years, today it was 2014, it's 2021 right now. It took me 7 years, the prime youth of my life, to overcome the depression that I was in, to fight the cases, to be feeling what it is like, at the lowest phase of your life. And then realize that nobody will come to help you if you are not willing to help yourself. I did not get an emotional support in that moment of low phase. Aapke ghar wale bhi jo hote hai na, wo unko samaj ki zyada padi hoti hai. Log kya kahenge? What will people think? They really do not focus upon the pain which the person is going through, whether it's a man or a woman. Divorce is a milestone of your life, jiske baad aapka life shayad change ho jane wala hai. And it is second only to a death in the family. Koi shaadi ye soch ke nahi karta ki hum divorce le lenge. You invest some time, energy, a part of your life with the other person, and suddenly you guys are snatched apart, door ho jate ho. It, there's immense pain. And coping up with that pain is equally painful, grieving for a man as a woman, you know. So, and I understand that because of the phase that I was in. And that is where today I made it my life purpose to be that support, that emotional strength to somebody who is in that phase and has not got the support. I understand what it means to have a shoulder, to have a hand to hold on to when you're in that lowest phase of your life. I wish I had that. I could have saved 7 years of my life. And 7 years is a huge potential, huge investment from your side, especially the youth years of your life. So if that can be saved, I will feel myself blessed to be coming here with a life purpose.
Taking a point from what you said, that people are always scared of, you know, log kya karenge. So if you talk about the Indian society, divorce is still very much discouraged and it's actually considered a taboo. And I see people saying that in a marriage, you should settle with compromises instead of just getting a divorce. So what message do you have for them?
See, frankly speaking, how we were 20, 40 years back is not how we are living today. Jo khana hum pehle khate the, the kind of food we used to eat, raw from the forest, is not the way we consume food now, right? The way we used to live in the caves and the brick houses is not the way we live now. We have evolved for the better, right? Similarly, our values and belief systems, which served us way back, 25, 40 years back, 50 years back, may not be the same if we are living in current society. That's the baseline, right? Which means we need to evolve our values, our beliefs, to be able to survive in today's generation and point in time. That said, jo hamare parents ne sikha, unhone wahi to hame sikhaya. They are also not wrong anywhere. But let me give you an example. I was always taught that bado ki baat mano, zaban mat ladao, jo keh rahe hain wahi karo. Is this a value that I would want to give to my child, my girl child? No. I would want her to be able to express herself, put her logic and thinking and decide for herself what is right and what is wrong. Aaj, if she doesn't have that, she'll not be able to survive. People will eat her. She'll be again vulnerable, right? We want to give better values to our kids. Similarly, in the case of marriage, now that I'm saying, these values and beliefs which served our elder generations, ki shaadi mein tike raho, bane raho, we have served them. But now in the generation that we are living in, a few people who were courageous and walked out of their marriages realized that they can live a much happier life. Bahut logo ne shayad unko taunt kiya hoga, tang kiya hoga, disbelief ke saath unhone ye kiya bhi hoga, step liya hoga with courage. Today they become case studies that yes, I'm much more happier. These people actually become very good friends with their ex-husbands, ex-wives, and they are co-parenting consciously so well. People who are living together in a toxic relationship, zabardasti reh rahe hain, wo bhi nahi khush hain, unka bachcha bhi nahi khush hai, wo shayad ek chhat ke niche hain, par wo saath rehte nahi, saath khate nahi, aur shayad sote bhi alag hain kisi aur ke saath. क्या फायदा ऐसी शादी का जब आप शादी में ही नहीं हो. शादी इज टू पीपल कमिंग टुगेदर. इट्स नॉट जस्ट स्टेइंग अंडर द सेम रूफ एंड हैविंग डिफरेंट. इट्स रूममेट्स देन एंड नॉट कपल, राइट? सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड, बिकॉज इट इज ओनली वन लाइफ, वी रादर लिव इट हैप्पीली. वी रादर, द डे यू रियलाइज यू हैव वन लाइफ, the day you realize you have one life, that day your second life begins. You may not want to lose it over people who do not value you, who do not want to be with you. Today, if I force you to be friends with me, it'll be your choice whether you want to be friends with me or no, right? Just because it is a kuch mantra padh liye aur saath mein, with all due respect, I'm not saying that the cultures are meant to bring people together and bring the families together. But if they are not doing the right purpose of bringing in happiness and nurturing the child, आप अपने बच्चे की जिंदगी खराब कर रहे हो. उसके एक्सपेक्टेशन उसके पार्टनर से कैसे होंगे आगे? वो देख रहा है आज आपको लड़ता हुआ. So these are the things which you really need to keep in mind while you know, deciding should I stay or should I move on. It may have served some people, but if it's not serving you, if it is becoming emotionally and physically dangerous for you to stay there, please take a decision. Lot of people stay on the edge of the cliff whole of their life, not able to decide, main aage badhu ki piche jaun? Should I take a divorce or should I stay in the marriage? You know, if you want to stay in a marriage, go to a marriage counselor. They'll help you resolve marriage. Aapki theek ho jayegi. If you want to move ahead, there is a divorce recovery coach. They will help you to restart your life and earn the respect back. Face the world again. But you're standing at the edge and not able to take a decision. That's the worst thing that can ever happen to anybody. If you restart your life again, you at least have new opportunities, a new perspective in life to look up to. Agar aap wahi khade rehte ho, it's like being stuck in a decision. Main ye karu ki na karu, puri zindagi usi mein chali gayi. Forget improving, you are stuck where you were. So it's up to the people to decide what they really want to do with their lives. How courageous are they? Gauri.
So because you help both men and women with divorce healing, you would be aware of some of the key differences in their experiences. Can you share those with us?
Absolutely. And, you know, a few interesting aspects, good that you're asking that question. I'll refer to my notes also, because I'll throw some key statistics at you as well. 70% of the people who get divorced, 70% of the people who get divorced are because of the minor reasons of the everyday crisis. Okay. Now, let me tell you, women are they have a tendency of grieving when they are sad, when they're going through a separation or a divorce. They grieve and they let out. They speak, they take professional help. Talk to their family members or friends, and that's how they grieve. And because of which they are able to overcome this, they join social groups, whatever. For men, they skip the grieving part. That is what the Indian culture has been teaching men to be macho, to be able to handle things by yourself. And मर्द को दर्द नहीं होता, ऐसे भी मिथ्स आते हैं आगे, राइट? यू कैन नॉट ग्रीव, यू आर अ मैन, यू कैन नॉट क्राई. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल दैट दे कीप ऑल दिस पेंट अप इमोशंस इनसाइड, जिसके वजह से उनके एंग्जाइटी के और डिप्रेशन के चांसेस बहुत बढ़ जाते हैं. बाय द वे, लेट मी टेल यू, व्हेन अ डिवोर्स इज हैपनिंग, व्हेन अ पर्सन इज इन डिप्रेशन, a man has 70% higher chances. Let me repeat that figure again. 70% higher chances of thinking of committing a suicide as compared to a woman, because she opens up, she reaches out for help, she's more social, vocal about, and that's where her emotional strength comes in. That is why mental and emotional strength is what it matters. The second difference is that men's health decline way too fast. Weight fluctuations, anxiety, insomnia, raat ko nahi so paate, you know, more so because it is a financial loss for them. It's an identity loss for them. For men, it's much more a financial burden for that matter, as compared to a woman, and an identity loss itself. Why do I say identity loss? Let me explain that. For a woman, identity loss has a very different meaning than for a man. For a woman, when I say identity loss, she does not know where she belongs anymore. Maa papa ne kanyadan kar diya, and now she belongs to her in-laws. That's what aapne gaay daan kari shaadi mein, the Indian culture, what do they say? Gaay ko daan kar diya aapne. और लड़की आपकी हो गई, अब सारी जिम्मेदारी आपकी. Like, these are the kind of cultures we live in now today. If she's coming back and she's in pain, then you don't want to look into her life. No, we've given away the girl. You don't want to take responsibility of her. And the in-laws also don't want her. So this is an identity loss. She's a football in the air. She does not know where am I supposed to land. That's identity loss for her. For a man, let me tell you what identity loss means. When they are married as a couple, it's a major part of their identity is who they are as husband and wife, right? When they part ways, a woman catches on and goes on, you know, she becomes a part of so many social groups. She tries to move on. She speaks to friends, therapies, and move on. But for a man, he does not grieve openly. So he avoids social circuit and he restricts himself to a inside of himself. He does not speak. For him, relieving stress means coming to his wife and speaking about the stress. But for a woman, releasing stress means speaking to a professional or a family member or a friend. When this wife is no more, then he doesn't know how to grieve. He is not accustomed to reaching out to anybody else beyond her spouse to express his stress. So when that person, that identity is lost in his life, he does not know whom to turn on to, and he goes into a self-medication phase where he consumes drugs and alcohol and tries to cope up with the grief, which has its own adverse effects. So identity loss means he is not able to see himself as a husband to a wife, because wherever he used to go in social circuits, he would always have his wife with him. Now with that wife gone, he avoids the social circuit altogether. He's lost his identity. For a woman, contrarily, she joins more groups. She tries to do more activities and move on with her life. While identity crisis for her is from what will be my surname for that matter? Where do I belong? For a man, it's a very different meaning of an identity. Apart from that, the third important thing, the difference between coping up with stress for men and women is the fact that men miss their kids a lot. The children, which are born out of this estranged marriage, usually come under the custody of the woman, right? Men usually miss their children, and they hate to call up their children and ask what is happening in your life. They miss them in the everyday life. They miss the weekends when they would go out and play, the parties, the bonding over dinner. You know, calling them every time to ask what's happening and then getting to meet them only on occasional basis, the custody schedule, whatever it is. You know, they really feel bad. There is a huge vacuum created for the kid. Bachcha to dono ka hi hai na shaadi mein. The woman gets the custody. She finds it a little more fulfilling and to avoid her negative, unproductive thoughts by investing time with her kid. You know, she still has the custody. There is no vacuum for her. But for a man, the vacuum is much higher because he is missing not only the wife, but the kid as well. He may not want the wife, but he still wants the kid, right? That is what creates even more an anxiety for men, you know? So, yeah. And another thing is men rush into relationships very fast because there is a vacuum and they always have been relying on their partner to take care of his needs, even the health needs for that matter. There always are chances that he wants to bounce back into another relationship. Mind you, he has not got the time to grieve enough to release all the negative emotions and take professional help and come out of it. He's not done any of that, but he still wants to get into another relationship, which causes troubled relationships again. He's again, without resolving what went wrong in the old marriage, without grieving properly, when he goes into a second marriage, he sees the same patterns getting repeated again in his life. Then he breaks the second one, goes into a third one, again same patterns, and ends up wondering, why is it that I'm seeing the same patterns in my life again and again? You know, not realizing that those patterns are coming from you within. It's you who needs to change rather than changing your life partner. The day you realize that the problem is inside and it needs to be cured here, आपने एक हिरन को देखा है, a deer, उसके नाभि में कस्तूरी होती है, right? And that deer runs around the whole jungle to figure out ये खुशबू आ कहाँ से रही है, not realizing that वो कस्तूरी वो खुद ही लेके घूम रहा है, that inner light, enlightenment, that wisdom lies inside of us. और हम उसको बाहर दूसरों में ढूंढते रहते हैं, वो गलत उसने किया इसीलिए ये हुआ. फर्स्ट लुक एट योरसेल्फ, दैट रियलाइजेशन हैज टू बी इनसाइड, द जर्नी हैज टू बी इनसाइड, द चेंज हैज टू बी इनसाइड, राइट? इफ एंड फॉर दैट मैटर द वुमेन दे टेक मच लॉन्गर अ टाइम टू गेट इन टू अ रिलेशनशिप. द रीजन बींग दे फियर गेटिंग इन टू अ रिलेशनशिप, स्पेशली इफ दे हैव चिल्ड्रन विद देम. वॉट इफ things didn't go wrong? And that way women are more emotionally strong because they spend time to understand why things went wrong, and that makes them emotionally more resilient.
Please share any two key things you have learned from all the experiences in your life.
The first and the foremost thing that I would like to tell you is start loving yourself a little more. We always prioritize others' needs over us, and we are always standing last in the queue to take care of ourselves. Matlab sabko khana khila denge ghar mein, uske baad hum khana khayenge. For the men, let everybody, you know, do this, then I'll be the last one to do this. I am the provider, and the woman thinks I am the nurturer. तो हम सबके नीड्स को अपनों से आगे रखते हैं और अपने आप को लास्ट कर लेते हैं. अगर हम अपने आप को इक्वल इम्पोर्टेंस देने लग जाएं अपने नीड्स को भी, एंड आई थिंक यू वुड हैव नोटिस्ड अ लॉट ऑफ मेन डू दैट अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम, इंस्टेड ऑफ ब्लाइंडली अग्रीइंग टू एवरीथिंग, यू नो, टू व्हाट द अदर पर्सन इज सेइंग, यू मे वॉन्ट टू लर्न टू ड्रॉ बाउंड्रीज. दैट्स द सेकेंड थिंग, बाय द वे, आई वॉन्टेड टू टेल यू कि आप अपने आप को उतना प्यार करो जितना आप दूसरों को करते हो. दैट्स द फर्स्ट थिंग. और दूसरी चीज, बाउंड्रीज बनाना सीखो कि आई विल बी एबल टू हेल्प यू टिल हियर, इसके आगे आपकी जिम्मेदारी है, राइट? इमोशनली, मेंटली, यू हैव टू बी टेकिंग केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ. इफ अ वुमन इज रिलाइंग टू मच ऑन द मैन, इफ द मैन इज रिलाइंग टू मच ऑन द वुमन, I think that's where the equation goes. You have to be learn able to take your complete self responsibility and draw boundaries. This is how it is. You learn to respect each other. When two people are whole and complete among themselves, that is when they become good companions, good life partners. But if you try to patch up two half apples together, they will never become a whole complete. कहते हैं ना, द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ बेटर हाफ डज नॉट रियली वर्क. इफ यू आर कंप्लीट बाय योरसेल्फ, शी इज कंप्लीट बाय योरसेल्फ, बोथ ऑफ यू कम टुगेदर एंड यू बोथ बिकम कंपेनियंस, राइट? कॉम्प्लीमेंट ईच अदर रादर देन कंप्लीटिंग ईच अदर. दैट्स द डिफरेंस, राइट? एंड वेरी ब्यूटिफुली, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इवन एक्सप्रेस, how do you say, self-prioritization, let me explain that in one more manner. I will be able to keep other people happy around me only if I am happy. If I am upset, everybody around me gets upset. Today, a man walks in the house and, you know, the kid is playing. Wo chota bachcha bahut khushi se khel raha hai, jumping around. And you are in a very angry mood. It could be a man or a woman. And she walks in and says, "Badmashi band karo, you know, stop making a noise. I have come from such a stressful work." आपने क्या किया? अपना वो stress और anger दूसरों को भी दे दिया. वो बच्चे को क्या पता? वो किसी और को क्या पता? If you see somebody happy, happiness is equally contagious. If you are stressful and you pass on stress, stress is equally contagious. तो पूरे घर में कोई शोर नहीं मचाएगा, कोई बात नहीं करेगा. Why? Because one person is upset and angry today, right? So, you know, if you can take care of that little innate thing, if you are happy, you'll keep everybody around you happy. If you are stressful, you'll make everybody stressful, right? दूसरों को खुश रखने के लिए आपको खुद खुश रहना जरूरी है. पहले ये समझ लीजिए, दैट इज सेल्फ प्रायोरिटाइजेशन, कीपिंग योरसेल्फ हैप्पी. आई विल सर्व एवरीबॉडी फ्रॉम द ओवरफ्लो ऑफ माय कप. इफ माय कप इज फुल, इफ आई एम एम्प्टी, आई विल कीप सीकिंग. मुझे प्यार दो पहले, मुझे रिकग्निशन दो पहले. यू नो, यू कीप सीकिंग, यूर अ टेकर. बट वेन यू आर फुल ऑफ लव एंड हैप्पीनेस एंड जॉय, you'll be able to give others the same thing, right? You squeeze an orange, you will get orange juice out of it, right? Whatever is inside you will come out of you also. So be careful of what you're giving out to the world. Learn to self-prioritize and keep yourself happy. Tabhi aapke aaspaas aap logon ko khush rakh sakte hain, varna nahi. Aur dusri cheez, boundaries banana seekhiye ki aap itna karoge aur iske aage nahi karoge. कॉम्प्रोमाइज करने के बजाय आप उसको कॉम्पनसेट करिए. कैसे कॉम्पनसेट करेंगे? टुडे योर मदर इन लॉ कम्स एंड सेज यू विल हैव टू स्किप योर ऑफिस टुमारो बिकॉज आई हैव अ किटी पार्टी एट होम एंड यू मस्ट हेल्प मी. एंड सो व्हाट डू यू डू? सो व्हाट, सो यू कैन इंस्टेड से, मॉम इट्स अर्जेंट, आई हैव टू गो टुमारो टू ऑफिस, आई कांट टेक अनप्लान्ड लीव्स. व्हाट आई कैन डू इज I will help you today. I'll make, prepare two salads and I'll, you know, give it to you. उसके बाद आप आके उनकी मदद करो. Office से आने के बाद, office जाने से पहले, you help her in the kitchen, do all the preparation. ठीक है, आप हर एक को हर समय खुश नहीं रख सकते, लेकिन आपने compensate भी तो किया ना. Do not feel guilty about it, because you ultimately have to balance your life out. आप नाराज रह के, एंड मेन डू दिस अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स. रिमेम्बर, इफ यू सी मैन कि आप, यू नो, मेन यूजुअली एंड अप सेइंग कि अभी मुझे काम पे जाने दो, मैं रात को आके तुमको डिनर पे ले जाऊंगा. यू नो, मेन कीप डूइंग दिस अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम. इट्स द विमेन हु नीड टू लर्न टू डू दैट एज वेल. कॉम्पनसेट करना है हमें. आज आप बच्चे को नहीं ले जा पाए, लास्ट मोमेंट पे कुछ काम आ गया, पेरेंट टीचर मीटिंग में आप नहीं जा पाए, या बच्चे को आप नहीं ले जा पाए जू, अभी कुछ ऑफिस की अर्जेंट मीटिंग आ गई, तो आप उसको कल डबल कॉम्पनसेट कर दीजिए. डू नॉट फील गिल्टी अबाउट इट. कल आप उसको पूरा दिन घुमाइए भी, फिर रात को डिनर भी कराइए, यू नो, एंजॉय द होल डे विद देम. बट लर्न टू मैनेज एंड बैलेंस लाइफ. यू नो, यू कैन नॉट कीप एवरीबडी हैप्पी एंड स्टॉप जस्टिफाइंग योर सेल्फ एवरीवेयर. पीपल विल अंडरस्टैंड, but you have to learn to say no respectfully, politely. Gauri,
we've talked a bit about this before, but some couples stay in a loveless marriage for the sake of their kids. And what do you think, is that okay, or does them fighting constantly have a worse effect on the child than them being separated?
Okay, let me try answering it in a little broader perspective. Why should you stay in the marriage if it's toxic, huh? So, theek hai, one aspect is, the first reason why you should continue to stay in a toxic marriage first is, if you are scared of yourself to face the real you, you continue to stay in the marriage. Kyunki baad mein तो बाद में तो बहुत सारे चीजें सामने निकल के आने वाले हैं, एडिक्शंस आपके सामने निकलने आने वाले हैं, विच यू मे नॉट बी कंफर्टेबल विद. द सेकेंड रीजन, इफ यू रियली लव योर चाइल्ड, यू मे वॉन्ट टू पार्ट वेज. कॉन्ट्ररी, दिस इज वेरी कॉन्ट्ररी टू वॉट द करंट जेनरेशन थिंक्स अबाउट, कि हमें बच्चे के लिए साथ में रहना है. एंड आई एम टॉकिंग हियर विच कुड बी वेरी रेवोल्यूशनरी. नाउ कम्स द मॉडर्न पार्ट ऑफ द मीराबाई. It is, if you really love your child, you may want to rethink about how you are living your lives. What values and belief systems are you building for your kid, right? Today, aaj main agar apna life partner seek karti ya karta hoon, I look for qualities which subconsciously I'm looking for qualities which were there in my mother or my father, right? वो वैल्यू सिस्टम्स जो हमने बचपन में सीखे हैं, वो जो इनिशियल 5-7-10 साल होते हैं बच्चे के, आर सो क्रिटिकल एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज वहां उसके लाइफ के फाउंडेशन बन रहे हैं. अगर वही डैमेज्ड है तो वो सेम बिलीफ सिस्टम्स को कैरी करके अपने लाइफ में आगे ले जाएगा और वहां पर वो सेम चीजें अपने लाइफ पार्टनर में भी ढूंढेगा. अ वुमन बीइंग ओके विथ हर हस्बैंड हिटिंग हर, getting physical with her is a proof that she has, क्योंकि उसने बचपन में भी शायद अपने घर में domestic violence देखा है और उसके लिए बहुत normal सी बात है. आज वो इस relationship में है जहां पर उसको लग रहा है कि okay, मुझे मार पिट रही तो ठीक है, गलतियां गलती करते हैं तो मार पिटती है, ये उसने देखा हुआ है. It's a belief system, right? That we all are living with. Learning to, this is where if you want, आप तो शायद चले जाओगे, यहाँ रहोगे भी नहीं, बट इफ योर किड इज स्टेइंग इन दैट टॉक्सिक रिलेशनशिप, वो जिंदगी भर आपके जाने के बाद भी आपको गालियां देता रहेगा कि ये आप क्या देके गए हो मुझे संस्कार, ये क्या वैल्यूज देके गए हो. मैं जानती भी हूँ ये वैल्यूज गलत है, मेरे को सर्व भी नहीं कर रही है ये वैल्यू सिस्टम, पर मैं फिर भी उन्हीं वैल्यू सिस्टम्स में रहती हूँ. ताकत नहीं है मेरे अंदर इतनी, मेरी पर्सनालिटी, मेरे सोल में इतनी ताकत नहीं है कि मैं उन सिस्टम्स को चैलेंज कर सकूं, उन बिलीफ सिस्टम्स को तोड़ के अपने लिए एक नया बिलीफ सिस्टम, एक नई जिंदगी शुरू कर सकूं. मैं कोसती भी हूँ पर फिर भी यहीं रहती हूँ और गाली देती हूँ जिसने मुझे ये सब सिखाया कि क्यों करते थे आप लोग ऐसे. कोई लॉजिक ही नहीं है. हम बड़ों से पूछते हैं ना, आप ऐसा क्यों करते हैं, उनके पास कोई लॉजिक ही नहीं होता कि वो ऐसा क्यों करते हैं, बस करते हैं, यू नो. सो For staying in a marriage, a toxic marriage, it doesn't serve anybody, you, your partner or the kid. It really doesn't serve anyone. If you are parting ways, teaching the kid to be happy and self-sufficient are the lessons that you really should be giving the kid. Aap ghut-ghut ki zindagi jee rahe ho aur bacche ko bhi yahi sikha rahe ho. Isse to achha hai, alag ho jao. Initial thoda trauma hota hai, lekin लाइफ अडेप्ट कर लेती है. दैट्स द ब्यूटी अबाउट लाइफ. किसी का लॉस या ग्रीवेंस जब कोई चला भी जाता है ना, व्हेन इवन समबडी पासेस अवे, वी आर आफ्टर अ फ्यू इयर्स वी आर एबल टू कोप अप विद इट, राइट? टाइम हील्स व्हाट वी से. देयर दिस इज कॉल्ड हेडोनिक स्ट्रक्चर. आर लिविंग हैज हेडोनिक स्ट्रक्चर्स वेयर वी आर एबल टू अडेप्ट टू द बेस्ट ऑफ द सिचुएशंस एंड द वर्स्ट ऑफ द सिचुएशंस. जो चीज जब आपको प्रमोशन मिला था आप इतने खुश हुए थे, क्या आज भी आप उतने ही खुश हो? जब किसी की डेथ हुई थी आपके फैमिली में तो आप बहुत नाराज, बहुत दुखी थे, क्या आज भी आप उतने ही दुखी हो? दिस इज वेयर हेडोनिक ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस कम इन. दैट इज हाउ वी आर बिल्ट. इट्स अ ह्यूज सब्जेक्ट विच इज बींग स्टडीड अंडर साइकोलॉजी एज वी टॉक हियर. Everybody has the capability of adapting and moving on. हमें लगता है कि अरे हम चले जाएंगे उसके life में से तो वो cope up कैसे करेगा या करेगी, you know? खुद भी परेशान हो और हमको भी परेशान करो. But that's not the truth. That's not the truth. Gauri.
So I've come across incidents in arranged marriages, especially where divorced men have it a bit easier when it comes to getting remarried. And women comparatively have it a bit tougher. So do you think such a difference really exists?
Let me answer it in two parts, okay? One is reality versus perception. Hum perceive karte hain. Aaj, married men, as we said, divorced men, they do not get time to grieve and they rush into second marriages. We've established that. Because of that, their desire to get into the marriage is much faster and quicker. So for the demand for women is always there, let me tell you. Yeah? The perception is ki bahut mushkil hai shaadi karna. The reality is there is a lot of demand for women in this second marriage market. There is a huge demand. Reality versus perception. Second cheez, aap agar us aurat se puche kya wo shaadi karna chahti hai ya wo dusron ke dabav mein aake shaadi karna chahti. Lot of married women prefer not to get married. prefer not to get married, while a few others believe it is important for them to get married because unke aaspaas ki society ka pressure bahut zyada hai unke upar. जो प्रेशर को झेल ले जाती हैं, वो कहती है मैं शादी नहीं करूंगी, हो गया मेरे लिए बस, आई रियली नीड टू फिगर थिंग्स आउट फर्स्ट. लेकिन जो प्रेशर में आ जाती हैं, उनको लगता है कि शादी के बगैर तो उनकी जिंदगी नहीं चलेगी. सो इट्स अ माइंडसेट आल्सो. द सेकंड आई सेड रियलिटी वर्सेस परसेप्शन. नाउ आउट ऑफ एक्स नंबर ऑफ वुमेन हु गेट डिवोर्स्ड, इफ 50% से आई डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू गेट मैरिड, देन द नंबर ऑफ women to get remarried to has also got reduced, right? Men are wanting to get married, remarried, but there are lesser number of women who are wanting to get married. So demand to aur bhi zyada ho gayi na, itni demand and supply, right? So perception chahe kuch bhi ho ki shaadi karna dobara bahut mushkil hai, lekin sachchai ye hai ki dobara shaadi to sab karna chahte hain. And here I'll throw a statistic. 72% of the people who get divorced, and I'm reading the statistics, 72% of the people who get divorced end up getting remarried once again in a lifetime. 50% people out of those, 50% people out of those remarry within 5 years of the divorce. आप 5 साल के अंदर दोबारा फिर से शादी कर ही लेते हो. और एक और स्टेटिस्टिक मैं आपके पास फेंकते हूं. योर चांसेस ऑफ सेकेंड मैरिज फेलिंग इज 15 टाइम्स हायर इन द नेक्स्ट 3 years. Why? Because you have not worked on your previous belief systems. The patterns are getting repeated. Yeah? Whether it's a man or a woman, they end up getting remarried 70% of the times. 50% उसमें से 5 साल के अंदर शादी कर लेते हैं. और जो शादी करते हैं पहले 3 साल में आपका ब्रेकिंग, यू नो, ब्रेकिंग द सेकेंड मैरिज ऑल्सो इज 15%. इन स्पाइट ऑफ ऑल दिस, इट्स द वुमन हु हैज द चॉइस. द वुमन हु रियलाइज दैट दे हैव द चॉइस, दे हैव द पावर टू डिसाइड हुम दे वांट टू गेट मैरिड टू, दे विल चेंज देयर लाइव्स एंड द लाइव्स ऑफ द पीपल अराउंड देम. अगर आप सोचते रहोगे कि मैं एक बोझ हूं, मुझे किसी ना किसी से तो शादी कर लेनी चाहिए, सेकेंड मैरिज इज नॉट अ रिकवरी फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट मैरिज. लेट मी टेल यू, जस्ट गेटिंग रीमैरिड डजंट रिजॉल्व द इश्यूज. यू नीड टू सिट डाउन एंड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आर द थिंग्स दैट वेंट रॉन्ग इन द मैरिज, व्हाट आर द लर्निंग्स. वो क्या चीजें थी जो मैंने गलत की शादी में. हर एक की गलती होती है ना, इट्स 50-50 पार्टनरशिप. मैंने क्या गलत किया जो मुझे नहीं करना चाहिए था, और वो क्या चीजें थी मेरी पार्टनर में जो मुझे अपने नेक्स्ट पार्टनर में नहीं चाहिए. यू नो, यू हैव टू डेलिबरेट अबाउट ऑल दीज थिंग्स बिफोर गेटिंग इनटू अ सेकंड मैरिज. लेकिन क्योंकि उस लड़की की जिम्मेदारी कोई लेना नहीं चाहता, उसको जबरदस्ती दूसरी शादी करवा दी जाती है. यहां तक कि वो लड़की खुद अपनी जिम्मेदारी नहीं लेना चाहती. If she had taken her own self-responsibility, she would say, I'll manage myself. I'll begin to work. I'll begin to cook. I'll do whatever. I'll take care of myself. But she is also in a denial state and she is wanting to latch on to somebody instead of taking her own self-responsibility. Same is with the man. A man has always been dependent on his wife to take care of his health. हर समय बीवियां ही तो बोलती हैं अपने हस्बैंड्स को कि हेल्दी रहो, ये करो, ध्यान रखो. टुडे नाउ विद द वाइफ गॉन, देयर हेल्थ कंटिन्यूज टू डिटेरियोरेट एंड देयर इज नोबडी टू टेल देम. सो दे इंडल्ज इन सेल्फ मेडिकेटिंग देमसेल्व्स विद व्हाटएवर दे वांट. दे रियली क्रिएट दैट वैक्यूम फॉर देमसेल्व्स. आज आप बोलिए, इन इंडिया द मेन वुमेन रेशियो इज, द वुमेन इज मच लेसर, एंड आई एम टॉकिंग ऑफ the population in the country. The women are lesser than the men. Do you agree? I may not have the right statistic, but the girl child born is lesser than the men, the male child.
Yeah.
From that statistic, imagine there already is a higher demand for the girl to choose whom she wants to get married to. Divorce ke baad bhi, ye ratio badhta chala jata hai. ये रेशियो हर समय बढ़ता जाता है. द गर्ल्स आर ऑलवेज इन डिमांड. आपको यकीन नहीं है, आप ऑनलाइन डेटिंग ऐप पर जाके देखिए. आई एम अ स्ट्रॉन्ग प्रपोजर ऑफ ऑनलाइन डेटिंग. इमीजिएटली तो शादी करनी ही नहीं चाहिए. करिए, डेट करिए थोड़े टाइम और उसके बाद डिसाइड करिए. दैट्स अनदर टॉपिक व्हिच आई एम वांटिंग टू डिबेट ओवर एंड ऑल टैबूज दैट गेट डिस्कस्ड राइट हियर. करिए, डेट करिए, वहां पर आपको खुद दिख जाएगा. द डिमांड फॉर द गर्ल्स इज सो सो हाई, रियलिटी चेक आ जाएगा आपके सामने. सो दिस परसेप्शन दैट इट्स डिफिकल्ट फॉर वुमेन विल गेट थ्रोन आउट इमिडिएटली. गौरी,
so I came across a post on your page announcing that you're releasing a book in 2022. Tell us a little bit about that, and how do you think it's going to help women in a society that is very largely patriarchal?
Absolutely. I'm so glad that you went through my page so well and studied, read about it. I'm honored that way. Well, this book is called The Happy Woman. It forces you to look at your definitions of marriage, your definitions of being happy, sorry. आपको कैसे खुश रहना है, ये फोर्स करेगा आपको फिर से अपनी डेफिनेशन ढूंढने के लिए. औरतों को पता ही नहीं होता कि खुशी किसको कहते हैं. व्हाट इज योर डेफिनेशन ऑफ बीइंग हैप्पी? यू डोंट नो. टिल यू डू नॉट नो व्हाट हैप्पीनेस मींस, यू कैन कीप चेसिंग. किसको आप चेस कर रहे हो जब आपका गोल ही क्लियर नहीं है, तो आप रह कैसे सकते हो हैप्पी? आई वॉज स्पीकिंग टू वन ऑफ माई मेंटीज and she said you know, we decide what happiness means to us, and I was like yes. She said mere paas husband hai who takes care of me, my kid is doing well in class, my mother in law okay relations with her, my career is okay, I wish my boss was a little more, you know, I have a full happy fulfilled life, this is happiness for me. Jab maine khushi define ki apne liye और मैंने वो खुशी अचीव भी कर ली, मेरे बच्चे को अच्छे मार्क्स आ गए, पति को प्रमोशन आ गया, मेरे को भी बॉस कंसिडर कर, देन आई डिफाइन माय हैप्पीनेस एंड आई गेट माय हैप्पीनेस, स्टिल व्हाई डू आई नॉट फील हैप्पी? व्हाट इज मिसिंग? आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड. बिकॉज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ हैप्पीनेस इटसेल्फ इज रॉन्ग इन आवर हेड. व्हाट डज रियल हैप्पीनेस मीन फॉर अ वुमन? द बेसिक्स हैव नॉट बीन केप्ट इन प्लेस. हमको हमेशा यही सिखाया गया है, आपकी फैमिली खुश तब आपका हक है खुश होने का. मैं यहां पर एकदम कॉन्ट्ररी बोलने जा रही हूं टू द कॉमन बिलीफ ऑफ द सोसाइटी. अगर आप खुश तो आपके आसपास सब जने खुश. लर्न टू प्रायोरिटाइज योरसेल्फ फर्स्ट एंड दैट इज वेयर यू विल ब्रिंग इन हैप्पीनेस. द गर्ल्स आर नॉट टॉट दिस एंड दे ग्रो अप विद दिस बिलीफ सिस्टम एंड से this is what my happiness is, they do not define it, and this is where it is going to help.
So apart from your book, is there any other project you're working on?
Absolutely, there are big plans which are coming up, and I'm super excited to share those with you. My course around divorce recovery is what is in the wings. At an individual level, I have been mentoring, teaching, working with these men and women. But if I really want to create an impact, and my life purpose is to definitely reach out to 1 million people who are going through divorce and separation to improve their quality of life, help them restart a new life and earn their respect back. With that mission in mind, I definitely need to increase the impact that I'm creating. For that, I am creating a course, a digital course around divorce recovery, so that more number of people can access it. My time is limited, but the courses will ensure that a lot of people who are going through this this painful phase of their life can access it. And ultimately, the objective is to help as many people as possible. Apart from this divorce recovery class, the coaching course is coming up. I also have my book, which is coming up. There is a course around the book itself, The Happy Woman. I'll be creating a course around this itself, teaching women how to reclaim their happiness. How do you define happiness for yourself? It's not just about pointing to them and saying, hey, your definition is wrong. Here, we are helping you to define your happiness as well, tell you what real happiness is. Beyond that, as I mentioned, the definition of happiness for men and women is very different. how they seek, how men look at things and how women look at things is very different. So there are a lot of things which are coming up for the men as well, the estranged men. I'll be addressing them as well. There is a book and courses coming for that segment as well. So a lot of things in the pipeline. I'm super excited to be here with you and telling all the plans that I have for the years ahead. Another 2-3 years, you'll see a lot of things happening and coming up. Got it.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I think I gained a lot of wonderful insight on just everyday things. And I actually got to know a whole new perspective, a whole new side of things I never imagined. I'm very excited for your book to come out, by the way. And all the best for everything with your future.
Thank you so much, Gauri. It was wonderful to be here on your platform. I look forward to being a part of your setup once again. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.